Hi Leo, welcome to my channel. This is Chelsea. Thank you so much for liking and subscribing. I really appreciate your love and support. I do your reading almost daily and I upload your videos right away, so these messages are current. In this reading, we are going to get you some important love messages. Please bear in mind that this is a general reading and it will not resonate with each and every one of you. Spirits and angels, please show me important love messages for Leo today. Someone here is acting that they have moved on, but they haven't yet. And Leo, this could be you or the person whom you could be thinking about or dealing with. Roles can be reversed. We've got the Knight of Swords here in reverse, and this is your energy, fire, unless your person has fire somewhere in your chart. But I'm sensing you are possibly ignoring somebody right now, and you're not speaking with somebody with the Knight of Swords in reverse. Unless it's your person or this person doesn't who's not speaking with you right now. Seven of Swords can indicate some sneaky behavior, but also can indicate somebody pretending, right? Pretending that, you know, I'm not speaking with you right now and I'm not doing anything, I'm not showing any interest, just to lead you in believing that I've already moved on. That's what I'm getting here. Again, it could be you or your person. Roles can be reversed. Ten of Wands is right here. Ten of Cups here is in reverse. And Five of Swords. Another card that indicates like a pretentious energy, right? Deception. So this deception, I feel like has more to do with somebody acting like they don't care. They don't want to speak. And Ten of Cups here in reverse. Because maybe there's trouble in paradise between you and your person if you have somebody right now. Or if both of you are separated. Ten of Wands, deep down, it's been really tough for this person to move on. I feel like there's this energy of somebody wanting to sneak their way back into your life or vice versa. Justice here is in reverse. So there's this energy where somebody feels this is not fair. So I'm going to teach this person a lesson by not either speaking to them or not doing anything with them. We've got the Ace of Pentacles and the Three of Wands, but someone here is waiting for the right moment or waiting for somebody to offer them commitment to start over. If this is someone from your past or that both of you currently could be separated, if you're completely single and you have nobody right now and you're not interested in anybody from your past, it does feel like Ace of Pentacles, there is something new that is about to happen. It's definitely a new beginning, right? If you look at the Ace of Pentacles, it looks very promising. But Three of Wands is right here. If you're completely single, there could be somebody new whom lives far away from you. Because Three of Wands is a bit of a distance energy that I'm getting here. This person either lives very far away from you or has a different background, ethnicity. But it feels like right now, for a lot of you, actually, you could be dealing with somebody or you could be separated from somebody, and there are some complications here. I feel like, again, this complication is because someone thinks, again, it could be you or your person, someone thinks this is not fair. This is not fair. So I'm going to do my best to walk away from this person. I'm going to do my best by not speaking to this person. But actually, I want to, but I'm not going to. Because spouses can indicate playing mind games as well, right? And the World here can indicate distance. For those of you in a long distance relationship, someone could be planning to travel towards you or you travel towards this person. Possibly trying to mend things, because Ten of Cups here is in reverse. If things have been kind of rocky between the two of you, or if both of you are separated and this person lives far away from you, there's this energy of planning. Somebody could be planning to travel to this person and then start have this new beginning with you or you with them. That will be an offer. Whether it's going to be accepted or rejected, that's definitely another whole different story, because it feels like it could be kind of like on the fence, because we've got the Three of Wands here and Justice here is in reverse. So one person is more keen and the other person is like, I'm not too sure. Okay, so we've got the Six of Pentacles in reverse and the Nine of Cups in reverse. So some dissatisfaction. Someone is very dissatisfied. Again, Six of Pentacles in reverse. This card also has a weighing scale. Yep, it has a weighing scale. Same goes to the Justice here. So something is lopsided. It feels one person is more invested than the other, or somebody may be feeling like they're being treated unfairly. Hence, they're very unhappy with the Nine of Cups here in reverse. So there's this strategy of maybe if I block this person, Two of Swords, if I don't speak with this person, maybe this person will come around. Maybe this person will give me what I want. Again, it could be you or your person. And Nine of Pentacles here is in reverse. It can indicate somebody being single and not going to be single that long. So for some of you, Leo, if you are single, it feels like maybe you're not going to be single for too long. But the Two of Swords can also indicate there is a choice. Either a choice for you to stay single or to accept this offer with the Ace of Pentacles. Or it could be a choice between two person. And also we've got the High Priestess here. So Spirit's definitely encouraging you to use your gut feelings, your intuition to make your decision here. But the High Priestess and the Two of Swords here also can indicate silence. Again, there's this silence game that somebody could be playing right now, right? With you or you with your person. Two of Swords, I don't want to speak right now. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Because maybe someone could be suspecting as well that this person has somebody else. That's why they're not speaking. So I feel like it's more like a suspicion that somebody may be, you know, sneaking around to be with somebody else. But it may not always mean that. It could also indicate like somebody wants that person to think that they have somebody else, right? Because again, this sneaky energy, Seven of Swords and the Five of Swords, feels like somebody doesn't want to lose in this game. Somebody wants to win. Basically, I feel like it's due to ego, and also somebody here could be thinking, it's just not fair, whatever he or she has done to me or is doing to me. So I'm not gonna let them off the hook that easily by playing some games or by, you know, not speaking to this person, you know. Silent treatment or silent war here with the High Priestess, and also we've got the Hangman. Some of you, maybe you're just thinking, you're just when it comes to your love life, for those of you who are single, maybe it's kind of like stagnant, or it could be a choice. Some of you could be a choice just to be alone for a while, or for some of you, you just feel like maybe there is no, if you're looking to meet somebody new, you may be feeling like it's stagnant, you can't meet the right person for you. Maybe because also you can be quite picky, right? And picky is not bad at all. Picky is a good thing. I'm picky as well. So we've got the Fool here. The Fool can indicate freedom, right? Freedom or starting a new chapter, starting a new journey. Some of you could be contemplating that. You could be thinking, you know, maybe, you know, I should just travel and be single for a while. Or maybe I need some time to be alone or just get away so that I can clear my mind. Or it could be the person whom you could be dealing with right now. Maybe they need some time to be alone, and they need some time to do their own thing and then come back when it's the right time. Because we've got the Three of Wands here. It feels like waiting for the right time to offer a new beginning. So we've got the King of Swords here in reverse. Another card that indicates somebody doesn't want to speak right now, right? Or somebody is not speaking the truth. But the King of Swords in reverse and the Fool here, yeah, it feels like someone may, again, Two of Swords, I don't want to speak, I just want to get out there and do my own thing. Because again, the Fool indicates some sort of a freedom. I want to experience freedom first before I get into a relationship. I want to see what is out there. Will I feel much more fulfilled if I'm single or doing my own thing? Or will I feel much more fulfilled if I'm in a relationship? Because Two of Swords again can indicate somebody is like kind of indecisive, right? Sitting on a crossroad. Again, this could be you or the person you could be thinking about or dealing with. Four of Pentacles is right here. Some of you could be saving money. Spirits also could be encouraging you to save money. Don't overspend it. If you're going to travel, you know, maybe not spend too much money. Nine of Pentacles here is in reverse. Choose wisely where you're going to stay, how much you're going to spend. Perhaps, you know, Four of Pentacles also can indicate you managing your money properly. Spirit's going to be telling you to do that. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, you might lose some money if you overspend. You might find it hard to save money. That's just for some of you. This is a love reading, but on the side, I definitely see something about your finances here. But Four of Pentacles can indicate you maybe are closing your heart chakra in the meantime and not allowing anybody to come in that easily. Or it could be the person you could be dealing with right now. Their heart chakra may be closed and maybe they need some time to be alone. They don't want to speak right now. And eventually, maybe they will come around because it feels like they're going to try and sneak their way back in. Offer you this new beginning if this is someone you could be dealing with currently. But if you are single, there is a new beginning here. Feels again like maybe this person lives far away from you. All right, Leo, this is your reading. I hope you resonated. If you did, please hit like, share, and subscribe. I'm gonna leave you with a playlist on the screen right now. It says Asia. It's from my second channel. It's a travel vlog channel. And also I'll leave you with another playlist on the screen. This playlist says bonus compilation reading, so it has all of the readings that I've done for you for the rest of the signs. And recently I've been experimenting, I've been exploring, you know, new questions, new type of readings. Hence I've been doing all of this collective reading, but I've got a lot of, you know, like comments or requests or some complaints saying that they would like more of the what do you call the single horoscope reading. So I'm going to try and balance both out, and I don't know, I just want to do something different because I don't want to be stagnant, you know. But anyway, thank you so much for, you know, being really understanding, being with me all this while, ever since I started my YouTube channel. I really appreciate it. And Leo, take care. I'm also open for personal readings. If you'd like to book me, my information is in the description box below. All right, take care. Bye.